Welcome students to this open learning forum provided by Odisha State Open University. Today we'll be discussing about one of the important theory of leadership that is called behavioral theory of leadership. One of the episodes we have discussed about trait theory. Now traits, since there is no unanimity among the experts with regard to the foundation or core traits which determines a leader from non-leader, in that circumstance the behavioralist came with a new theory which take into account the activities of a leader, or that is called behavioral theory. As you know, in 1940s and 50s, behavioralism came into existence in management. The behavioral school, when it emerged, perhaps the founder could be McGregor with his theory XY. Now focus was shifted to behavior aspect. And in this behavioral theory of leadership, three schools play prominent role. One is Ohio school. So let's discuss about the Ohio school first. Subsequently, we will be discussing about Michigan school and managerial greed by Blake and Morton. Ohio school tried to find out two important behavior of leaders. So they have divided the behavior into two components. One is initiating structure. Second one is consideration type. So they found out these are in two dimensions: initiating structure, consideration type. Now, what is initiating structure? The leaders who give importance to initiating structure, they try to find out mainly about the role, rules, regulation to be followed by the followers. So initiating structure gave importance to the structure, the rules, the roles. They fix the role for the manager, fix the role for the other non-managerial post, and they emphasize that the role has to be carried out as mentioned by them. So initiating structure more towards the productivity, whereas consideration type or consideration behavior focuses on followers, that is on employees. They become very adaptive towards employees' qualities, consideration towards employees, or employee friendly, try to solve employee problem, and they focus on employee development and employee satisfaction. Now the question comes, which type of leaders are better? The answer, if you want productivity in the organization, then perhaps it is the initiating structure type of leaders. If you want the employee to develop, to participate, you need to solve the problem of the employees, and so that employees will be satisfied, then it is the consideration type of leaders. And some theorists, again, while implementing this theory, they come out with the suggestion that a leader should be high in initiating structure and consideration type. This is a deadly combination. If at all possible, naturally the leader will be able to increase the productivity as well as satisfy the employees. Next school of Michigan school. Michigan school simultaneously carried out study on the behavioral aspect. They divided the leaders into employee oriented, production oriented. Now employee oriented and production oriented, at the beginning they put them in a single continuum. One side employee oriented, one side production oriented. Later on they found that there is a difficulty. These two leadership behaviors cannot be put in the same continuum. So they again changed it and they divided into two categories. And similar to Ohio School, the production-oriented leaders are like initiating structure type of leaders of Ohio School. The employee-oriented leaders are similar to consideration type in Ohio School. And this study again is accepted by many and followed by many, that leader should have employee-oriented behavior and production-oriented behavior. But combination of these two qualities, again, we find rarely occurring in persons. Now, after these two theories or two schools within the behavioral theories, the next research was done by prominent persons like Black and Morton. They came out with a managerial grid. Instead of two types of leaders, they put leadership into different types. They put a scale in x-axis, 9 scale, production oriented leaders or leaders focusing on production, that is on x-axis, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Similarly, on the y-axis, so Black and Morton, they have come out with a new theory or the new proposition that is called managerial grid. In a managerial grid, they put two qualities in two axes. Y-axis is employee orientation and x-axis production or productivity. X-axis they divided into 9 scale, whereas the 9 is the highest. Similarly, y-axis is divided into 9 scale, 9 is the highest one. And the leaders can be 9-1 type, 9-9 type, 1-9 type, 1-1-5-5. As you know, the first one or any deciphration of XY axis, the first numericals talks about X axis. So 9-1 means X axis 9, Y axis 1. So 9-1 leader are focusing on what? They are focusing on productivity. More on productivity, less on employee relation. So these are authoritarian leaders or authoritative leaders. They always give direction. And another category of leader could be 1-9. 1 in the X axis, 9 in the Y axis. And these leaders are more employee oriented, less concerned towards production. And we call them as country club style. And these leaders are good in managing people, satisfying people, solving people problem, working along with the people. The best form of leadership is 9-9. X-axis 9, Y-axis 9. So X-axis 9, Y-axis 9 is the highest one. So they focus both on productivity as well as on employee relationship. And they are called best managers. Now another category could be 5-5. They are leaders who can manage most of the things. We call them adequate leaders. And these leaders focus on productivity and focus on employee relation. Now, one category left, that is 1-1 leadership. And we call them as impoverished leaders. Or in other sessions, we have discussed about laissez-faire or free-reign leadership. They neither focus much on productivity nor on employee relation. But they can be successful only when the supporters are having the skill, knowledge, and enthusiasm or the willingness to do the things, who do not need any supervision, any guidance for the growth of the organizations. So these three schools basically promoted behavioral theory. Now the question again arises, why is behavioral theory is appropriate every places? Can a leader having employee-oriented behavior and behavior on production, which is important, and can he lead in all situations? Perhaps the behavioralist could not have much answer to this question. That's why this theory, along with trait theory, searches for a new theory. And when researchers are searching for a new theory, behavioral theory again become complementary to trait theory, and the new theory emerges is contingency theory. In another episode, we'll be discussing about contingency theory. I hope you could able to grasp over behavioral theory and the three schools under behavioral theory. Thank you.